Well, this is my newest little tool slash toy. It's an Echo SRM 225. I just bought it at Home Depot for about $300 Canadian. I know they're $200 in the U.S. You know, I got to tell you, it's a pretty good little machine. I like it. I looked at a few before I bought this one, and this is the one that I chose. I like the handle. Handle feels good. Bit stiff there for an old fellow like me, a weak old fellow like me. But yeah, you know, I'll tell you, for the money, years ago, when we bought our first house, we were out in the country, and I had a big Tanaka, and it was similar to this in the sense that it was a straight shaft, but it was a solid steel shaft because I could put blades on it. But I don't need that anymore. I'm in town, and I just need to cut grass, and I was tired of pulling around an extension cord with my electric. So I started looking for them when I bought this. But you know, when I look at the build quality, I'm really quite impressed by it. Let me see if I can get a good shot here. I mean, I don't know where it's made. I'm trying to get this thing focused. It says Yamabiko Corp. You can't read the rest of it, but Japan. Now, I don't know if that's the parent company for Echo, or if the power head was made in Japan. Look, I can tell you, it works really well. For a homeowner, man, I tell you, it does a great little job. Little 21-something cc engine, 50-to-1. Mix comes with a little pair of goggles here. I know they're cheap, but you know what? They work. These things kick up a lot of dirt. One thing that I did, it's just because of me, but over here, I took this bolt out just to make sure there was grease inside this little head. And I just took a little zip tie and I just stuck it in there to see that there was grease on the tip of that zip tie. Got a bump head, you know, I believe that's 0.95. I bought an extra pound of string and I tried to measure, you know, like hold up the package of string to that, and the package of string I bought was 0.95, so I'm pretty sure that's 0.95. Anyways, it doesn't matter. It does the job. But some of the comments I read on the Home Depot Canada site said it worked, the unit worked well for a couple of years, and then after a couple of years it wouldn't start. But I think that the people gave no more information. They didn't give any feedback as to, is there any spark? Is there gas getting to the plug itself? Like, is your plug wet? You know, I'm not so sure that the criticism was a fair criticism. I know that there's really not much that can go wrong with a two-stroke engine. This is a simple little two-stroke engine. By the way, I did look at the Hondas this morning. They were a lot more money, but they were a four-stroke engine, made in Thailand. I'm guessing probably typical Honda quality, but you know, just it's nice to have a two-stroke. They're so simple, really, really simple. I mean, typically, if you mix your fuel properly, and this is a 50-to-1 oil mix, and you know, you either put fuel stabilizer in it in the fall, or do like I do and just run the things dry. Well, you know, there's really not much that's going to go wrong with these things. So I'm not sure with these reviews that were critical if that stuff had been done, right? You never know. Anyways, good little machine. Very comfortable. Glad I bought it. I think it's going to last me, well, as long as I need one.